Today is the day we stop mixing up these super important genetics terms. Hi, biology friends, it's Sarah, your other biology professor, and let's talk genotype and phenotype. We're going to start with the phenotype. So phenotype is what we observe about an individual for whatever characteristic or set of characteristics that we're interested in. Phenotypes are descriptive or measurable. Phenotypes can be physical characteristics, things like flower color or height, or they can be behavioral, aggression, herding behaviors, or physiological, more on the level of cells and molecules, like blood cell counts or hormone levels. The genotype is an individual's genetic makeup, its own unique sequence of A's and C's and G's and T's. We often narrow that down, though, and focus on the genotype for a specific gene or a particular region, location of DNA called a locus. Genes can exist in different versions, different DNA sequences, and we call those alleles. So you can also think about genotypes as the alleles that an individual carries. And you could show an individual's genotype as the actual DNA sequence of their alleles, but that gets a little bit hefty, so what we tend to do is use letters, numbers, or symbols as a sort of abbreviation for alleles. For humans and most other animals, we inherit one copy of each chromosome for each parent, so two copies of each chromosome. We're diploid. And that means two alleles for any given gene or locus we found in the genotype. And that can be two of the same allele, homozygous, or like here, two different alleles in the genotype, heterozygous. And when you have a heterozygous genotype, so bringing together two different alleles, you can have cases where one allele is dominant over the other, but that's a totally different video. The genotype can influence the phenotype. What's on the DNA can influence how that characteristic is observed. But how much the genotype influences the phenotype depends. An individual's environment can also play a role in impacting phenotype. As an example, think about two genetically identical trees, so same genotype, but one tree is given more sunlight, more nutrients. Even though their genotypes are the same, only one of them is going to grow to its full height potential. If you're feeling a little bit more confident in telling the difference between genotype and phenotype and identifying in a problem which part is the genotype and which is the phenotype, please give me a like so that other students can find this as well. In the meantime, subscribe for more biology content and tips and tricks from me, and I will see you next time.